The North Celestial Pole is the point in a circle around which all other points appear to rotate. This means that scientists can obtain all kinds of information about Pluto and other planets by studying their motions around this pole. NASA's James Webb Space Telescope will soon demystify the realm of Pluto and many other icy worlds. It's going to investigate the Andromeda Galaxy to reveal how galaxies form and evolve, as well as explore planets outside our own solar system. Pluto's mysterious haze could be explained by its encounter with a planetoid. A NASA mission to Pluto in the next decade will also reveal if there are bodies of comparable size beyond Earth. After its launch in December 2021, the JWST has already sent back breathtaking photographs of distant exoplanets, intricate nebula nurseries, and galaxies whose light took more than 13 billion years to reach our sight. It is possible that its destination may soon be the huge disk just beyond the orbit of Neptune, known as the Kuiper Belt, which is home to comets, asteroids, and other frozen bodies. In addition to its status as a dwarf planet, which it gained in 2006, Pluto is also a Trans-Neptunian Object and a Kuiper Belt Object. Planetary scientists consider Pluto to be a Trans-Neptunian Object, in addition to the fact that it is one of the most massive Kuiper Belt objects that have ever been discovered. There is a significant amount of unexplored territory beyond Neptune, and this includes Pluto. However, efforts to locate them with the use of JWST have already started. What is the Kuiper Belt? Because of its orbit, Neptune is located within the region of 30 to 50 AU of the Kuiper Belt, which is an outer disk of the solar system. Gerard Kuiper first introduced the data of the Kuiper Belt in 1951. Sometimes, the phrase is expanded to include Kenneth Essex Edgeworth, who first characterized the region in 1943. As a result, the region is sometimes referred to as the Edgeworth-Kuiper Belt. Jonathan Lunine, a planetary scientist at Cornell University whose research interests include the study of extrasolar planets and Kuiper Belt objects, is a member of the science team for the JWST. Kuiper proposed that there would be a population of objects left over from the formation of a giant planet that would sit at the orbit of Neptune and beyond, he explained. Kuiper proposed that there would be a population of objects left over from the formation of the giant planets. In addition to Pluto, the Kuiper Belt is also home to the comet known as Halley's, as well as the minor planets Eris, Haumea, and Makemake. How JWST will study the Kuiper Belt? As JWST continues its quest to explore the universe more deeply and sensitively than any other telescope, it will gain a new perspective on Kuiper Belt objects. Since Kuiper Belt objects are small, cold, and far away, the sensitivity of the instrument to infrared light will allow for successful detections, according to Lunine. JWST's biggest strength is its capacity to acquire images using infrared spectroscopy and its extremely high spatial resolution. By observing the light reflected from Kuiper Belt objects using JWST's cameras, scientists will be able to determine what kinds of atoms, molecules, ices, and minerals are present in these worlds because of the absorption and emission lines they see. JWST spans a large wavelength range, so we will see where these various compounds that may be on the surface have their fundamental vibrations, added Lunine. Scientists plan to use these telescopes to identify materials that were previously undetectable with those situated on Earth. By expanding their orbits farther from the Sun, Uranus and Neptune push the Kuiper Belt further out, dispersing dwarf planets and smaller things into its donut-like region and away from it, hurling some closer to the Sun. It is believed that Neptune plucked the ice moon Triton out of the Kuiper Belt. Geological activity has been detected on the planet Triton, which is thought to be an ocean world and has a diameter of approximately 1,056 miles. Despite the fact that both Eris and Pluto were previously planets, Eris is much less well-known than Pluto. After its discovery in 2005 by astronomers Mike Brown, Chad Trujillo, and David Rabinowitz at the California Institute of Technology, which contributed to Pluto's disputed downgrade from planet to dwarf planet, scientists initially assumed that it was bigger than Pluto. However, more recent research has shown that it is actually smaller than Pluto. Eris, the Greek goddess of contention, was chosen to be the namesake of this dwarf planet since it is now believed to be roughly the same size and density as Pluto. Thousands of objects have been identified by watchers in the Kuiper Belt, and hundreds of thousands more are likely waiting to be found, according to astronomers. There are thousands of KBOs ranging in size from tens of kilometers upwards, Lunine stated. Constant close encounters, collisions, and planetary interactions drive objects out of the Kuiper Belt. Actually, the Kuiper Belt is shrinking as more and more objects break up and drift away. Uncovering the Kuiper Belt with JWST. The two science proposals for the Kuiper Belt have paved the way for JWST to begin studying these faraway worlds soon. Proposal 1273 is led by Lunine and aims to study the dwarf planet Haumea, the KBO Quaoar, the Amicus Trojan asteroid, and three Centaurs, 2008 FC76, Pholus, and 2002 KY14, which are located between Jupiter and Neptune. In the meantime, Proposal 1272 will investigate the moon of Neptune, Triton, as well as the minor planet Sedna. These are only the preliminary reconnaissance studies with JWST. Subsequent observations will focus on Pluto and the additional dwarf planets Eris, Haumea, and Makemake. What we're attempting to do is share these data and combine them so we can investigate a number of these objects ranging in size from Pluto on down, explained Lunine. We will learn a great deal about the makeup of their surfaces and the location of the ice. However, not all of the Kuiper Belt discoveries are riding on the shoulders of the James Webb Space Telescope. It is anticipated that a new ground-based telescope in Chile that will be known as the Vera C. Rubin Observatory, previously known as the Large Synoptic Survey Telescope, would revolutionize the research of KBOs in a manner that is distinct from that of the JWST. It is the largest optical telescope ever constructed, measuring 6.5 meters in diameter and featuring a CCD image sensor with 3.2 gigapixels. According to Lunine, its optical system gives a very wide field suited to detect transient astrophysical and astronomical events and objects. Its optical system delivers a very wide field. One of those is KBOs that we don't yet know about. It's going to be a very important new discovery tool. If we can understand the formation of Pluto, it will help us understand how other planetary bodies formed and evolved. The James Webb Space Telescope is set to give us a peek at this region of space. So if space, the solar system, stars, and other astronomical things fascinate you and you want to explore space with us, let us know down below what topic we should cover next. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. We can't wait to see your feedback. Thanks for watching.